One of the common questions people often ask me is, what are 100% blockages? When we talk about 100% blockages in the coronary arteries, there are actually two types of 100% blockages. There's a recent occlusion, and this is a situation where somebody has a heart attack, for example, where the artery suddenly gets blocked off because of a blood clot or blood rupture. And that's a cardiac emergency. When you have a heart attack, the blood vessel closes off suddenly, patient has excruciating chest pain because the sudden cessation of blood flow. It's an emergency because arteries are not opened up, the patient may die of a heart attack. So in that kind of scenario, take that into a cath lab, do an urgent angioplasty, open up the 100% blockage, restore blood flow, and the patient often survive if it's done in a timely fashion. That is in the crux what a heart attack is. It's caused by a sudden occlusion, 100% blockage that can happen acutely. This is often a soft plaque because it's something that happened very recent. So these blockages can be dealt with quite easily by either sucking out the blood clot or putting a balloon to reopen that up and setting a stent, because the clot is soft, it's easy to open up the blockage. Now, there's another group of patients who do present as with 100% blockage, which has been around for a long time already, what we call a chronic occlusion. The medical term is chronic total occlusions, which is short for CTO. These are basically blockages which have been around for already a long periods of time. By definition, a chronic occlusion is an occlusion that is there for at least 3 months or more. In this case, the blockage is no longer soft like Swiss cheese, like as I said earlier, where you can easily pass a wire and balloon and open up. These are blockages which have been there for a long period of time already, and hence the vessel quite often harden. They may be calcified, and crossing this blockage can present as a real challenge to cardiologists, because it may not be very easy to pass a wire or balloon to cross these 100% blockages. So dealing with these 100% blockages is a technical challenge, and it's like one of the more challenging subset of patients that we deal with in the field of interventional cardiology. Are often surprised when they say they're still alive if they have 100% blockage. How can this be? Okay, well, as I explained before, the heart is supplied not by one vessel, but by supplied by a series of blood vessels. The coronary arteries is made up of at least three main arteries, two blood vessels on the left, the left anterior descending circumflex, and the major artery on the right is the right coronary arteries. From this, there are other smaller branches. They supply the various segments of the heart. So even though you may have a 100% blockage, you still have the other arteries supplying the other segments of the heart. So quite often you can still be alive despite the 100% block in one arteries. Of course, if you're 100% blocked in all the arteries, then the heart doesn't get any blood supply, then of course you won't be alive. But if you have a blockage in one of the arteries and it's 100% blocked, you can still be alive because there are still main blood supply to the other segments of the heart. And even the area which is completely blocked off, where there's no blood supply, one of two things will happen. That area could either die off and, you know, become scar tissue because they have lack of oxygen and blood supply, or that part of the heart will still be alive because it still gets blood supply coming from the other arteries which form auto channels. The body is quite smart. It actually, is able to create, auto bypass and form new channels to supply. From new tributaries and branches which will supply the occluded segment. So that part of the heart still receives some degree of blood supply, but it's often insufficient. So when you're at rest, it may not cause you any pain, but when you exercise, that part of the heart, because it doesn't get enough blood supply, may cause chest pains, or the heart may not contract as well, so the patient may feel they are short of breath, or the effort tolerance is reduced because of 100% blockage. So one of the challenges as a cardiologist would be to try to open up and restore blood flow in 100% blocked artery, so that the patient can then receive full blood supply again and have an improved quality of life and increase their exercise tolerance and eliminate their chest pains.
Thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you do, please don't forget to like, share, and comment. Thank you.